Welcome back. My next guest is someone you're very familiar with. This is Lauren Solomon. Lauren is a fantastic, amazing women business owner, and I have become very interested in women business owners as of late. Just as I have spent the past several years trying to develop my own business, it is so difficult to do, and it takes so much grit and so much chutzpah, and Lauren has all of that and so much talent, and so it's so fun for me to be able to talk with you about this, about how you've developed your business and how you've taken what you're so great at and really made it into something amazing.
You know, like so many of us, I think if I had planned it, it would never be. Mm. So a lot of this just, it very much grew out of the moment that it was. Mm-hmm. So I was the in-house image expert for Chase Manhattan Bank. I had a full-time job that was about 80 hours a week, and then I had my own business that was 80 hours a week.
Wow.
So I would work for them. I used to say I work for them from 9 to 9, and I work for myself from 9 to 9.
So, and a little tiny nap in there somewhere.
Somewhere, but they say when you're an entrepreneur, any 12-hour day will do.
That's
pretty much the way it looks. But I really believe that out of a passion, if you are born to do something, mm-hmm. you must do it. And if you deny it, you can never be happy doing the other mm-hmm. things that you're doing. So whether you do it alongside something else or whether you do it as a full-time, and I was never a good corporate soldier. Mm-hmm. I was really challenged by a lot of organizational structure and felt mm-hmm. that it held me back. Mm. So
that makes a lot of sense. You know, some people really thrive in a structured environment, mm-hmm. and some people just crumble. And right. you know, and some people can do both, and you're obviously one person who could do both.
I could at the time.
Yeah,
I couldn't do it now. Now I am gainfully unemployable. No doubt.
So tell me more about your experience as you were the president of
I was the president of the Association of Image Consultants International, which was a volunteer position. That was not a job. That was me heading up my trade association in an effort to actually exhibit the leadership that I believe mm-hmm. needed to happen to move the industry forward. Mm-hmm. And so image is a very multifaceted but misunderstood kind mm-hmm. of a business, and I don't even know if our viewers know exactly what I do, but I am an image consultant and an executive coach. I specialize in all aspects of self-presentation, mm-hmm. Including appearance, etiquette, communication, presentation, and media on camera mm-hmm. work. So those are all things that have grown up out of everything that I was doing and everything that I loved. Mm-hmm. But the real shift came when I was actually in business school, and we were given an assignment to create a business we would love to walk out to tomorrow. So I was in the executive MBA program at NYU, mm-hmm. and we were given a marketing assignment to create a business that we would love to walk out to tomorrow. Hmm. And I was miserable in my day job. Mm-hmm. Again, crying myself to sleep 5 nights a week, not mm-hmm. enough concealer in the world mm-hmm. to cover my raccoon eyes. Mm-hmm. And here I got this gift of, mm-hmm. wow, what would I really do for the rest of my life if I could never retire and I had to work every day for the rest of my life, what would I do? Mm-hmm. And I designed it, and this was it.
Wow.
So
this is fantastic.
It's a gift.
So as a woman business owner, I would love to find out, you know, one or two tips that have really helped you grow this from the ground up. For other people who are watching, and for me personally, what has been the greatest kind of like trick or tip that has really helped guide you towards the success you've had?
So business hacks, I think, is what we're talking about, right?
You're right. What's the shortcut?
Like, what's the shortcut? I think the shortcut for me was trust yourself.
Okay.
Because especially women, we doubt ourselves and mm-hmm. we're distracted by so much of what goes on around mm-hmm. us. But I believe that trusting our intuition and knowing that if we're guided to do something, if we stay on the path of doing it, the guidance will come mm-hmm. every step of the way. Mm-hmm. And the second thing The second thing I would say is get your money in order. Because we are also not as focused on the money necessarily. People who are driven by passion are not driven by money.
That's right.
And the truth is, when you have passion, money goes out the window.
Yeah.
So we know it from when we find something we would love to purchase. The price is not an issue. If we want it bad enough, we'll figure it out. Mm-hmm. And that's the same thing with business. If you want your business to succeed, you can't give your business away in a way that lets you showcase it. You can do it to a degree, but you have to make sure that you're making money from the get-go. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, it makes it very hard to play catch-up on the back end. Mm-hmm. And I was very fortunate because when I left the bank, I had a little bit of a nest egg that I could start with. So I literally moved my 12 banker's boxes home, rearranged my apartment, created a full-fledged office, and I just kept working. But most people don't have that kind of a setup already. Mm-hmm. So create structure that works for you. So even though I say I'm not good with structure, it meant that my best working hours were usually about 8 p.m. to 4 a.m. Mm-hmm. No corporation was going to be okay with that.
Right.
So recognize that for me, I needed to have the freedom during the day, and then I could come home and have the clarity to work all night.
In the evening.
Yeah.
And
I was in New York City, so when the city got quiet, I got going with work.
See.
Because all day when the city was busy, I was zooming along too. And I may have been out with clients or I may have been doing business anyway, but that freedom within the day and the understanding that I actually sit down and do the stuff that needs to get done. And then hire somebody to do the stuff you either don't want to do, are not good at doing, or the things that don't make you money. Hire a housekeeper. Send your laundry out. If you need, hire your meals to come in. Hire an assistant who can do the running around that you don't have time to do. Get a scheduler on your computer so people can schedule their time with you and you don't have to even interact with them until that time comes. Make sure to cut away the things that are going to steal your energy and your time, and they're going to steal your focus.
Oh, this is so amazing. I'm so glad that we've got this videotaped so I can go back and take notes. The one thing that I have noticed for me too is I had a lot of hang-ups of hiring out when I started, when our business started growing. But I finally realized, I thought, you know, I have children and I have a job. And if I try to do all of the cooking and the cleaning and the housework at the same time, my kids are not going to get the attention that they need. And so once I got past the hurdle of I'm not lazy, I'm just managing my time better, then I just have so enjoyed not having to clean my house.
Whatever it is that gets in your way,
that's exactly
whatever steals your energy, steals your desire to do the work because you're too exhausted. And you need to make sure your children are the priority, your business is the priority. Then that's where you spend your time. Everything else can be done by someone else. And the gift is that there's someone else out there who's going to be better at it than you.
Yes, and I thought that was a really great point that you made also, and that will enjoy it, right? So I'm thinking of our COO of our company, Emily, who is a fantastic organizer and really enjoys managing schedules and people. And I think, oh, I'm so glad I don't have to do that. So that is such great advice. And I loved your advice also about taking care of the money, even though the passion and money don't often go together, because that is totally me. I'm like, oh, I want to do this and it's going to be so amazing for our clients. And then, you know, in the back of my mind, it's like, what about how much is this going to cost? I'm like, oh, it'll all work out. It doesn't matter, you know.
But then over time, you're giving and giving. And we do this at home with our families all the time. You're giving. And then all of a sudden you back up and you start to resent the giving and the giving, and it's no longer fun and it's no longer passion and now it's no longer a business, because you can't have that resentment build up and still move forward. The only way to stay in your flow, and the reason entrepreneurs do what they do, is because they are on a mission, they have a passion, they have an idea, and they have to go forward with it. So anything that takes you away from that is going to build resentment, whether it's money or making the bed. So realize that those two, you know, they kind of go hand in hand, but you must have the money, and you have to recognize that we're professionals and professionals get paid. Mm-hmm. And professionals pay. Mm-hmm. That means if you hire someone, you pay them because mm-hmm. you expect to get paid as well. Mm-hmm. You can, you know, there's barter and there's all kinds of other systems out there, but the truth is, nothing makes you feel quite as good as getting paid at the end of a good day. Mm-hmm.
And that's absolutely right. Thank you so much for all of these amazing tips.
This is so much fun.
I'm looking forward
to just this whole series.
Me too. It's going to be really wonderful. And to think of all of the amazing people that we have in Orange County, all the amazing women who own businesses that we can interview.
And I hope they'll show up for us.
And they will.
Absolutely. So we'll put it out there and they will come.
That's right.
Perfect.
Thank you so much for explaining that.
Thank you. This is great.
This is great. And we will be right back.